Mark chapter 16 verses 15 to 18. And he said to them, "Go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He who believes and is baptized will be saved, but he who does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will follow those who believe. In my name they will cast out demons, they will speak with new tongues, they will take up serpents, and if they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover." A person's last words are their most important. It was the same for Jesus. Before departing for heaven, he told his disciples what he wanted them to do. It was for this purpose that he had been training them throughout his earthly ministry. Go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Matthew recorded it in more detail. "Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you." In a nutshell, Jesus commanded us to go to all nations and make disciples. Isn't it simple enough to remember? Then why do you think most Christians have neglected this responsibility? The disciples' experience gives us the answer. It is because the majority of Christians have not met the resurrected Jesus that the disciples met. The disciples did not initially understand the mission of Jesus and were not ready to go to all nations and make disciples. However, after meeting the resurrected Jesus and receiving the Holy Spirit, they had a clear vision and purpose for their lives. From that time on, they had only one priority: to fulfill the Great Commission. If making disciples is not your only priority and purpose, you need to get to know Jesus more deeply. No matter where you are now in your relationship with Jesus, is it not your destination? You have to meet the resurrected Jesus and be filled with the Holy Spirit to make disciples. In case you missed it, making disciples is a command that was given to every single Christian. It is the sole job description of every believer. No matter what kind of a job you have, no matter how old or young you are, this is supposed to be our daily and lifetime purpose. As we fulfill the Great Commission in a different time and different circumstances, to the original disciples, Jesus will provide everything we need and protect us from any dangers. Are you a disciple-making Christian? Is your church a disciple-making community? From today, let's start in our small corner of the world and then move on to all nations, leading people to Jesus and preparing them for the kingdom of God. Go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature.